beautiful land. You've all heard of Cadbury's? Yes. Fries?
Yes.
Ron cheese?
Yes.
Nestle's?
Yes.
Wonka's?
What?
Why? What's Wonka's?
Wonka.
You mean you don't know what a Wonka is? Why? Wonka chocolate, of course. I admit Willy Wonka's chocolate is fairly new, but still, it is the greatest chocolate to ever be invented. What? Willy Wonka himself is the greatest maker and founder of chocolate to ever exist. He's invented things like, say, I'm not gonna tell you what he's invented. You came to see yourself.
Woo. So I'll let you do just that. But before I do, perhaps I should fill you on what's been happening around here lately. Because Mr. Willy Wonka makes the best chocolate in the whole wide world. Three other great chocolate makers, known as Mr. Figgle Grubber, Mr. Prodnose, and Mr. Slugger, have sent spies to work for Mr. Wonka in order to find out his secrets. Well, they must have been good spies, because soon afterwards, these three great chocolate makers began making such delicious Wonka favorites as ice cream that never melts, chewing gum that never loses its flavor, and candy balloons you can blow up in huge sizes before you pop them with a pin and gobble them up. Mr. Wonka didn't know what to do. He didn't know who the spies were, and if he continued to operate the factory, all his secrets might be stolen. So he did the only thing he could. He sent all the workers home and closed the factory.
You might think that would be the end of Mr. Willy Wonka, but no siree, not him. After months and months went by, the factory suddenly began operating again. The only thing that anyone could see were shadows dancing around in front of lighted windows. Mighty strange. Well, anyways, to get back to the story, soon there was a big article in town paper saying that Mr. Willy Wonka, in order to sell a lot of candy again, was running a contest. Yes, sir, that's right, a contest. He had secretly wrapped a golden ticket under ordinary wrapping paper in 5 ordinary candy bars.
The candy bars were said to be found anywhere, in any shop, in any street, in any town, in any country, in the world. The 5 upon any counter where Wonka's candies are sold. The 5 winners will tour Wonka's new factory and take home enough for the rest of their chocolate. 4 of the tickets have already been found. Oh, would you like to meet the 4 lucky people?
Yeah!
All right, listen and watch carefully. I think they're here somewhere. Let's see. Woo-hoo!
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for interrupting this program, but we have an extraordinary announcement to make that earlier today, Mr. Willy Wonka has decided to open his chocolate factory, the biggest and the most amazing in the world, to a few lucky children. There are 5 golden tickets, okay? 5 golden tickets hidden underneath an ordinary wrapping paper of 5 chocolate bars. News has just reached us that the first lucky golden ticket winner has been found. We now go to a live broadcast with our first lucky golden ticket winner, Augustus Gloop from Duffelheim.
And here we are in Duffelheim with our lucky winner, Augustus Gloop. As you can tell about the amount of noise, the town is bustling with excitement. Can I ask you, Augustus, how does it make you feel to be the first golden ticket winner?
Chocolate.
chocolate, food, hungry. I love food. Food, food, food.
Any other feelings?
This is gonna cost Wonka a fortune in a fudge.
Mr. Gloopy must be very proud of him.
When I was eating a normal chocolate bar, and then I tasted something. There was no chocolate, coconut, fruit, peanut butter. So then I looked, and then I saw the golden ticket. I celebrated by eating more chocolate. And my father calls me his little sausage wastage, but my real name is Augustus Gloop. You can say I've been training since the day I was a little baby. I train morning, noon, evening, all the time. But chocolate will always be my favorite food.
Thank you, Augustus, and enjoy your visit.
A Wonka Whippy Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight?
It's the best of them all.
Don't be too disappointed, dear, if you don't find what you're looking for underneath the wrapper.
Enjoy it, Charlie. Forget about all those golden tickets and enjoy the chocolate.
Yes, after all, it's a Wonka's Whippy Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight. It's the best of them all. I know you'll just love it.
We expected that.
We'll share it. I want everyone to taste it.
No.
You wouldn't dream of it.
It's all yours.
Please.
No. Charlie, it's fine. Just enjoy it.
Yes, Charlie, enjoy it.
It's your birthday, not ours. Oh, by the way, did you see the news?
No, Grandma Jo, what news?
The first golden ticket winner has been found. Some guy called Augustus.
Yeah, he looks like a big greedy nincompoop to me.
So, Willy Wonka opened his factory. Did that mean we'd be able to go inside and see Mr. Wonka?
Well, not quite. Willy Wonka has hidden like 5 golden tickets, was it? Yeah. Golden tickets underneath the wrapping paper of 5 ordinary bars of chocolate. Only the winners will be able to go inside.
Do you think I could be a lucky winner?
Why not, Charlie? You have as much as chance as everyone else.
But I don't get a bar of chocolate very often. The kids at school make fun of me because I don't get sweets.
At least you don't need to go to the dentist as often as those children.
By the time I come by my next bar of chocolate, all the lucky golden tickets will be found.
Come on now, Charlie. Your chance will come someday.
You've got you another one. Maybe that would have it. Try.
Across the globe. Wonka Mania! While we in the studios have been waiting to get you a live interview, police have reported ransoms in the form of Wonka bars. A famous London auction firm has just sold a large case of Wonka bars for an outstanding sum of money. While we in the studios have been waiting for the news of new lucky golden ticket winners, we found that two new golden tickets have been found. Would you like to meet these lucky people?
Yes!
We are now here at Alabama Heights with the Salts.
Come here now, Veruca dear. Let Daddy fix your hair.
Leave me alone. I look perfectly fine.
Shut up, Veruca. It's only a little interview.
So, Miss Veruca, how can you tell us a little more about yourself?
V-E-R-U-C-A. Veruca Salt. My daddy, I want my golden ticket.
Where's my golden ticket? I want my golden ticket.
My daddy always gives me what I want.
Some may say he spoils me, but I just say he loves me.
So last week I saw a poster about this some competition about a golden ticket. I didn't know what it was for, but I did know there were only 5 in the entire world. I told Daddy I must have one, and if I didn't get one, I would scream. Daddy hates it when I scream, especially when he's paid $50,000 for voice lessons. So anyways, Daddy told his workers to stop what they were doing and take the wrappers off the candy bars instead. And do you know what? That minimum wage hack tried to steal it. I had to wait a whole 3 days. And now I have my golden ticket. I still haven't got the 8 pony I asked for, and if I don't get one soon, I shall scream!
Mrs. Salt, perhaps you can tell us a little more on how the golden ticket was found.
You see, ma'am, as soon as my little girl told me that she simply had to have one of those golden tickets, I went out into town and buying up all the Wonka bars. I loaded them into trucks and brought directly to my factory. I'm in the peanut business, and I've got about 100 women working for me, selling peanuts and salting. So I've told them, okay girls, from now on, you can stop selling peanuts and start selling wrappers instead. And they did. It was awful. Veruca was getting more and more upset, and when the news came from Dusselheim about Augustus Gloop, she was lying on the floor, kicking and yelling. It was dreadful all seeing her. We do everything we can keep her happy and contented. It took 3 whole days before they found this golden ticket.
I wanted to be first!
Come on, Veruca, smile for the camera. Happiness is what counts with children. Happiness and harmony.
Of Miss Violet Bogart, winner of golden ticket number 3. Excuse me, Miss Bogart. Well, Violet, congratulations on winning the 3rd golden ticket. Would you like to tell the people how you found your ticket?
I have a lot of trophies. I am the world champion of sculptures, and I do karate. I'm gonna win that special prize because I'm a winner. I'm a gumchewer normally, but when I heard about these ticket things of Mr. Wonka's, I laid off gum and switched to candy bars in the hope of striking it lucky. Well, now of course I'm right back on gum. I just adore gum. I can't do without it. I munch it all day long, except for a few minutes at meal times when I take it up and stick it behind my ear for safety. To tell you the honest truth, I simply wouldn't feel comfortable if I didn't have that little wedge of gum to chew on every minute of the day. I really wouldn't. It may interest you to know that this piece of gum I'm chewing right at this moment is one I've been working on for over 3 months solid. That's a record, that is. It's beaten the record held by my best friend, Cornelia Prinsmitten. Hey there, Cornelia. She was furious. I'm thrilled to be going to Mr. Wonka's factory, and I understand he's going to give me enough gum to last for the rest of my whole life.
Thank you, Violet. This is the TV family, where 13-year-old Mike has gotten the 4th golden ticket.
Gosh, people see I'm watching TV. I wish you wouldn't interrupt me.
Will you tell us then how you found your golden ticket?
Well, I was watching TV, obviously, and then I just found the ticket. I just turned up the wire, and there it was.
I see, that's very...
Can't you people see that I'm watching TV? This show's an absolute whiz bangle. I watch it every day. I love gangsters best, especially when they pump each other up full of lead.
Sorry, Mike. I think we'll return to the studios when the search for the 5th and final golden ticket continues. Good night. Morning show. Today we discuss Wonka Mania. Have you heard about the golden ticket team?
Someone in South America found it last I heard.
Did they? Well, that's it then. I bought over 100 bars of Wonka chocolate. All my savings are gone.
Well, I got more than that. I even had a loan from my dad. I must have had about 176.
And now,
But let's see what the people of this lovely city think about Wonka Moon. Here we have with us...
Charlie Bucket.
Charlie Bucket, a young boy who's had how many?
Two.
Just two?
You just come that the last golden ticket was a fake.
Fake?
The plot is growing thicker, isn't it? And what is it you have there in your hand?
It's a 50 pence coin. And I looked around, but nobody seemed to have claimed it. And if it's okay, I'd like to buy a Wonka bar, please.
But you see, there isn't a single bar left in this city. And here, my dear audience members, where we need your help. Look around you, look under your seats, under your bottom, look in your bag, everywhere. Ransack this place if you must. But let us be the ones to help him help his way to Willy Wonka.
Everywhere!
Please, wait, open.
Let me see, there's some writings. Greetings to you, lucky finder of this golden ticket from Mr. Willy Wonka. Tremendous things are in store for you. In your wildest dreams, you would not imagine how, like, anything would happen. Charlie, you've done it!
Grandma, it says here that I can take someone with me. I wish you could come.
Me? I don't think so. Let's see. Come on, Charlie, help me up. Okay, let's try again. Okay, no. So, I did it! I haven't done it in 20 years! Possibly that. It says here the factory opens on the 17th of June. Why, that's tomorrow! Come on, Charlie, we haven't got a moment to lose!
my best.
You better have, or I'll scream!
No, no, Veruca.
Augustus, read. Augustus, please, Augustus, do try and keep some things for later on.
Must be the other golden ticket holders. Do you know who's who, Grandma?
I think I can tell by looking at them. The chewing one is Violet Beauregard. She chews one piece of gum for 3 months. That kid over there is Augustus Glue. Then the one with all the devices is Mighty V. It's a wonder how he hasn't got his square eyes.
So the one in the pretty dress must be Veruca Salt. I don't know whether I'm going to like her, Grandma.
I don't know, Charlie. She looks pretty on the outside, but I'm not sure of the inside. If she doesn't get what she wants, she'll scream.
I wonder, will she get everything she wants today?
No, I don't think so, Charlie.
Excuse me, we hear from the press. Please smile.
Thank you.
Grandma Jo, can
pleasure indeed, ma'am. Now, if you'll all please follow me, our tour is about to begin.
But you stay together. I wouldn't want to lose any of you.
And you will be in a world of pure imagination. I could go around in all fours and eat every blade of this grass like a cow.
What's the matter with your river, Wonka? Is it polluted?
It's not polluted. It's chocolate. Every drop of the river is hot, melted chocolate of the finest quality. There's enough chocolate in there to fill every bathtub in the entire country. The waterfall is most important because it mixes the chocolate, makes light and frothy. The bites suck up the chocolate, take it to all the rooms where it's needed.
Augustus, I don't think you better do that.
Augustus, you must come away. My chocolate must be untouched by human hands.
Augustus, did you hear what the woman said? Come away from that river at once.
It's fabulous. I need a bucket to drink it. You must come away. You're drinking my chocolate.
Augustus, you'll be giving that nasty cold of yours to millions of people all over the country.
Help!
Augustus, do something. Save him.
I'm not diving in there. I've got my best clothes on.
It's no good. If I did it now, he'd be sucked up by the pipe.
Augustus.
There he goes.
Augustus, come back at once.
Too late. Now don't worry, Mr. Gloop. There's no danger, no danger whatsoever. He's gone on a little journey, but he'll come out just fine. Just you wait and see.
How can he possibly come out fine? He'll be made into marshmallows in 5 seconds.
Impossible, unthinkable, absurd. He could never be made into marshmallows.
And why not?
Because that pipe doesn't go anywhere near it. The pipe Augustus went up goes directly to the room where I make my most delicious kind of strawberry-flavored chocolate-covered fudge.
Then he'll be made into strawberry-flavored chocolate-covered fudge. Oh, my poor Augustus. They'll be selling him by the pound tomorrow morning.
He'll be perfectly safe.
He'll be chocolate fudge.
Never.
And why not?
Because the taste would be terrible. Can you imagine it? Augustus-flavored chocolate-covered look. Ew. No one would buy it. Please take Mr. Gloop to the fudge boiler room and help him to find Augustus.
Augustus!
Quite changed from what he's been.
one of these gobstoppers, you'd bite your teeth off. And these never disappear. These don't think they do. Cacao, cacao. This Oompa Loompa has been sucking one of these gobstoppers for over a year now, and it's still as good as ever. Now, over here, I'm inventing a new line of toffee.
What sort of toffees, Mr. Wonka?
Hair toffee. You eat just one bite of it, and in about an hour or two, a new, luscious head of hair will start growing at the top of your head. And a mustache, and a beard.
A beard?
What's a beard, for goodness sake?
It would suit you very well.
But unfortunately, I haven't gotten the recipe quite right yet. But when I do, there'll be no excuses for little boys and girls running around with little bald heads.
But little boys and girls don't
go around with... Don't argue, my dear child. Please don't argue. Such a precious waste of time.
What's this machine doing?
Well, this machine just happens to make the most amazing and sensational gum in the world.
It looks like any other ordinary gum to me. And I should know. I'm an expert when it comes to gum.
Well, my dear Violet, this piece of gum
just happens to be an entire three-course meal, all in one.
Well, if it's gum, then I can chew it. Come on, Mr. Wonka, hand over this magic piece of gum of yours, and we'll see if this thing works.
Well, you see, I'd rather you didn't. I haven't gotten the recipe quite right yet.
I don't care.
No, the gum is
Wonka.
But I want one now.
Name your price, Wonka. What do you want for one of those geese?
They're not for sale. She can't have one.
Indeed.
size of that?
It has to be that big, because whenever you send something by television, it always ends up so much smaller.
Absolutely fantastic! It's a miracle!
Soon, you'll see an advert on television for Wonka's chocolate, and you'll simply be able to see it and grab it!
Can you send a person from one place to another?
A person? I guess you could. Wouldn't want to risk it though. It has some nasty results.
I'm gonna be the first person to be sent by television!
No!
Nay, alligator!
As long as his fingers!
Oh no!
you love my chocolate factory, Charlie?
Yes, Miss Wonka, I think it's the most wonderful place in the world.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, because